Hi students, how are you? I am Ram Kumar, zoology teacher from Madhya Madhuri Matric Higher Secondary School, Uttangarai. And then the 1970s worldwide dreadful disease, influenza virus. So it is very dangerous virus. Now 2020, the worldwide dreadful disease, coronavirus, and then pandemic disease. So all of you stay in home. Protect your health and our family health. So now go to discuss the topic, animal kingdom. Animal kingdom. Sir already discussed the topic. Classification of living organisms. Classification of living organisms and the basis for classification. Basis for classification. So one time we call classification of living organism and the basis for classification. Each and every living organisms, they are some basic classifications or presents. For example, Nizan, kingdom, and then phylum, and then class, and then order, and then family, and then genus, and then species, and then species. So that is the basic classification for living organisms. Go. For example, so human being. So the zoological name of human, Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens. So that is the zoological name of human being, Homo sapiens. So in this Homo sapiens, so what is one living organism? In this living organisms, based on the classifications, for example, the human being, kingdom Animalia. Kingdom Animalia. So phylum chordata, class mammalia, order primates, and then family hominidae, and then genus Homo, and the species name sapiens. So that is on classification of living organisms. Classification of living organisms. So the primate means, it is includes in human being, monkey, and tailless monkeys. So it is includes in primates. At the same time, hominidae. So monkey and human beings and then tailless monkeys includes in the family hominidae. So next one, basis for classification. So each and every living organisms, they are formed during the basic classifications or presents. And then basic classifications are level of organization, and then next one, symmetry, and then another one, germ layers, and then last one, silo. So that is the basis for the classification. So first one, level of organization. So how is formed one organism? Go on. And then atoms, the many atoms to form of molecules. Many molecules to form of cells. So cell is a basic structural and functional units of all living organisms. So many cells to form of tissue, many tissue to form of organ, many organ to form of organ system, organ system and many organ system to form out one organism. So that is a formation of organism. Go. So that is a organization of organisms. So in this method. And the next one, symmetry. Symmetry means the arrangement of body parts of an organism. So that is a symmetry. So based on the arrangement of body parts, the symmetry can be divided into three types. So one is a asymmetry. Asymmetry means absence of symmetry. And then next one, radial symmetry. Radial symmetry. And then last one, bilateral symmetry. Bilateral symmetry. So asymmetry means absence of body parts. And then radial symmetry, the arrangement of body parts as a central axis. If you cut the central axis of an organism, can be divided into many equal rods. So that is a radial symmetry. And then another one, bilateral symmetry. So bilateral symmetry, the arrangement of body parts as a central axis. If you cut the central axis of an organism, can be divided into two equal parts. So that is a bilateral symmetry. Go. And then next go to for germ layer. So that is on importance. Each and every living organisms, they are developed from the embryonic stage. So in this germ layers are mainly involved. So in this germ layers, during the development of an organism, the particular organs can be developed. So with the help of germ layers. So this germ layers can be divided into three types. One is here, ectoderm. Another one is here, mesoderm. And then last one, endoderm. So that is the three germ layers are present during this embryonic development. And the next one, coelom. Mostly in this on the coelom or on the body cavity present in the some organisms. For example, some invertebrate organisms. So based on the coelom can be divided into three types. So one is here, acoelomates. And then another one is here, pseudocoelom. And then last one is here, true coelom. So that is a coelom. Go. So next we go to for the definition of animal kingdom. Animal kingdom. So animal kingdom further divided into two groups based on the presence or absence of notoca. So that is an important word, notoca. So the animal kingdom further divided into two groups based on the presence or absence of notochords. So that is on two groups. One is here, invertebrata and vertebrata. Invertebrata is always known as non-cardates. Vertebrata is always known as cardates. Okay, then next is notochords. So what is notochords? So notochord is a rod-like structure formed from the mid-dorsal side of the body during this embryonic development. So that is called as notochords. So the notochord throughout the life of animals replaced by backbone. So the notochord is always known as backbone. So backbones. So the animal kingdom, presence and absence of backbones can be divided into two groups.
invertebrata and vertebrata. So invertebrata means when an organism do not possess the motor cards. So in this type of animals called invertebrata animals or non-chordate animals. At the same time, when an organism the possess notochords or backbones. So in this type of animals are called vertebrata animals or chordate animals or chordate animals. So next one, based on the absence of notochords, the invertebrate animals can be divided into many phyla. So one is here. Phylum Porifera, Porifera, and then phylum Coelenterata, Coelenterata, and then phylum Platyhelminthes, Platyhelminthes, and then phylum Ashelminthes. And then phylum Annelida, and then phylum Arthropoda, Arthropoda, and then phylum Mollusca, Mollusca. Phylum Echinodermata, Echinodermata, and then phylum Hemichordata, Hemichordata. So these are many phylums are present. So based on the options of backbones, the invertebrata can be divided into many phylums. So now go to discuss the first phylum Porifera, and then next the presence of backbones. So based on the presence of backbones, the vertebrata can be divided into many phyla. Phylum Cyclostomata, Cyclostomata, phylum Fishes, then phylum Amphibia, Amphibia, and then phylum Reptilia, and then phylum Aedes, and then phylum Mammalia. So that is a many phyla based on presence of backbones. The vertebrata can be divided into many phyla. So next go to for phylum Porifera. So 4 BS. Porifera means 4 BS. For example, sponges. Porous means pore. Fera means ears. So 4 BS or holds body upon organism. So that is the Porifera. For example, sponges. So that is on sponges. Zycon, this one is a Euspongia. Zycon and Euspongia. So this one is a Asplum, Asplum, and then this one is a Speculum. This one is a Speculum. So that is a one type of sponges, Zycon, and then this one is a Euspongia. Go. And then the term Porifera. Term Porifera was given by Robert Grant. Robert Grant. And then the study of sponges called parazoology. Study of sponges called parazoology. So next one, general character. General characters of sponges. Go. So first one, habitat. Habitats.
They are aquatic organisms. They are aquatic organisms. Aquatic organisms, and then some are fresh water and marine water sponges. Marine water sponges. So they are multicellular, non-motile organisms. So that is our importance. They are multicellular and then non-motile. Non-motile means without movements from one place to another place. So that is our non-motile organisms. And then next one, body form. So the sponges are colonial form. Colonial means group. So that is a colonial form. And then the body with many pores is called ostia. Ostia. So ostia means heart walls. Heart walls. So that is an ostia. So this one is a ostia. So the many pores are present in the organism. So that is an ostia. This otherwise known as asplum. And then next one, water canal system. The water enter inside of the body through the ostia. So this leads to water canal system. This leads to water canal system. So this water canal system, with the help of nutrition, respiration and excretion. And the excretion process. Go. And then next one. Level of organization. So the sponges are cellular level of organization. Cellular level of organization. Cellular level. Go. And then next one, symmetry. So asymmetry. So options are body parts. Go on. The next one, germ layer. Sponges are the first multicellular diploplastic animals. So that is an important. Sponges are multicellular diploplastic animals. Diploplastic animals. So diploplastic means when an organism developed during this embryonic stage, ectoderm and endoderms. So that is on diploplastic animals. Ectoderm and endoderm. So that is on diploplastic animals. Go. And then next one, body wall. So the body wall consists of speculus. Speculus. So speculus means the minute holes or sharp holes. So that is a speculus. And then in the speculus to form of skeletal framework. So that is a skeleton. In the speculus to form of skeletal framework. Skeletal framework. So many speculars are present. Many speculars are present. Go on. And the next one, digestion. Next one, digestion. So the sponges are take place in intracellular digestion. Intracellular digestion. So intracellular digestion means the digestion take place in inside of the body of organism. So next, digestion. So the sponges are take place in intracellular digestions occurs in foot vacuoles. Foot vacuoles. So what is intracellular digestion? So the digestion takes place inside of the cells is called as intracellular digestion. Go on. So intracellular digestion are take place in foot vacuoles of organisms.
And then next one, respiration. The respiration is followed by the process of diffusion. Diffusion. So what is called diffusion? The transfer of substance from high concentration to low concentration. So that is called as diffusion. For example, all aquatic organisms only respire through the dissolved oxygen. So dissolved oxygen means the atmospheric oxygens are enter inside of the water. So to form of dissolved oxygen. So during this aquatic conditions, the oxygen level is high concentration. At the same time, the body of an organism, inside of the body of an organism, the low concentration of oxygen. So during this diffusion process, the transfer of substance from high concentration to low concentration. So that is called as diffusion. That is called as diffusion. And then next one. Circulatory system absent. And then nervous system. Nervous system absent. Nervous system absent. And then next one. Excretory system. The excretory product of sponges called ammonia. So this all aquatic organisms is always called as ammonia telic animals. Why aquatic organism called as ammonia telic animals? Most of the aquatic organisms to produce a excreta or excretory product called ammonia. So in this type of animals are called ammonia telic animals. And then last one, reproduction. So both asexual and sexual reproduction. Both asexual and sexual reproduction are present in sponges. So asexual means when an organism to produce a young ones. When an organism to produce a young ones from the single parent. So that is an asexual. When an organism to produce a new individuals from both parents. For example, male and female. So that is an sexual reproduction. Okay, next we go to for second phylum. Phylum Coelenterata or Cnidaria. And then night means needle or sting cell. Sting cell. So example of Coelenterata, Hydra and jellyfish. Hydra and jellyfish. So this is Hydra and jellyfish. So that is on mouth, tentacles and then body. So this one is a tentacles. So that is on sting cells of an organism. So that is on sting cells. Go. And then the term Coelenterata was given by Leapcock. Leapcock. Go. And then general characters of Coelenterata. So first one is a habitat. They are aquatic habitats. They are aquatic habitats. And then some are free living in fresh water and marine water. Fresh water and marine water. And then next one, body form. So Coelenterates have mainly two forms. One is a dimorphism and a polymorphism. One is a dimorphism and a polymorphism. So what is dimorphism? two sexes are present in the same species called a dimorphism. Okay, and then another one, polymorphisms. So that is the different forms among the member of population. So that is called as polymorphism. And then next one, level of organization. Level of organization. That is a tissue level of organization. Tissue level of organization. And then next one, symmetry. So that is on radial symmetry. Radial symmetry. What is radial symmetry? Already told him. The arrangement of body parts from the central axis of an organism. If you cut on animals, can be divided into many equal laws. So that is called as radial symmetry. And the next one, germ layers. So that is on diploblasty animals. Diploblasty animals. So already told you, diploblasty, when an organisms developed during the embryonic stage, ectoderm and endoderm. So that is on diploblasty animals. And then next one, body wall. So the body walls consist of two layers, outer ectoderm and the inner endoderm. Okay. So the body wall consists of two layers, outer ectoderm and inner endoderms are separated by non-cellular jelly-like substance. So that is called as mesoglia. Non-cellular jelly-like substance called mesoglia. So this mesoglia contain glial cells or present. Glial cells are present. And then next one, digestion. So both intra and extracellular digestion. Both intra and extracellular digestion. So what is extracellular digestion? The digestion take place outside of the cell. So that is called as extracellular digestion. Intra means the digestion take place in inside of the cells. So that is intracellular digestion. And then next one. Next one, skeleton. Skeleton. Exoskeleton. Exoskeleton. So exoskeleton means to form of cells. The animals protected by the cells. So that is an exoskeleton. And then next one, respiration. So the respiration is followed by the diffusion process. Respiration is followed by the diffusion process. So already told him diffusion. Okay. And then next one, nervous system. So nervous system, the network of nerve cells are present. Network of nerve cells are present. And then another one, circulatory system absent. Circulatory system absent. And then excretory system. Excretory system. So the excretory product of sealant rata, mainly in ammonia. So that is an ammonia telly organisms. Ammonia telly organisms. And the last one, reproduction. Last one, reproductions. So both asexual and sexual reproduction. Both asexual and sexual reproductions. Next phylum, Platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes means flatworm. Platus means flat, flat, and then helminth means worm. So that is a flatworm. So the term platelminthes was given by Gangen Burr. And then general characters of platelminthes. So mostly parasites, and then some are free living in freshwater and marine water habitats. So the next one, body form. So the body is dorso ventrally divided and to form of platelet, and then without true segments. So that is a body form. And the next one, the level of organization. So that is on organ level of organization. So next one, symmetry, bilateral symmetry. So already told in bilateral symmetry. And the next one, germ layers. So that is on triploblastic animals. So when an organisms developed during this embryonic stage, there are involved in three germ layers. And then one is here, ectoderm, and then middle mesoderm, and then inner endoderm. So during this embryonic development, the three germ layers are involved. So that is on triploblastic animals. And then next one, body wall. So the body wall of platelminthes soft and ciliated. And then the parasitic animals or parasitic organism of platelminthes, the body wall is covered by thick cuticle and epidermis and muscle layers are present. So in these three layers may be covered. And then next one, body cavity. So body cavity, acelomates. So body cavity means when an organism, the inside of the body to form up a small cavity. So that is called as body cavity or coelom. So in this platelminthes, absence of coelom or absence of body cavity. So that is acelomates. And then skeletal system, digestion and the circulatory system absent. And then next one, respiration. So the gaseous exchanges occurs by the process of diffusion. So this diffusion process takes place in the body surface of an organism. So that is a respiration of platelminthes. And then next one, excretion. So the excretion process, it is occurs by the specialized cells called flame cells. So in this, flame cells are performed by the excretory process. So the excretory is product of platelminthes, ammonia. Okay. And then the flame cells, it is regulated by osmoregulation process. What is called osmoregulation? The maintenance of constant osmotic pressure of body fluids upon organisms, controlled by water and salt concentration. So that is called as osmoregulation. And then reproduction. Next one, reproduction. So reproduction, hermaphrodites. So what is called hermaphrodites? The both male and female reproductive organs are present in the same species are called hermaphrodites. So both male and female reproductive organs are present. For example, liver fluke and a tapeworm. Liver fluke and a tapeworm. So that is the structure of liver fluke. So that is a structure of liver fluid. That is on asplum. Go on. And then this one is a sucker. And then this one is a liver fluid. And then next one, tapeworm. Tapeworm, the heterogeneous to form of scolex. So that is on scholar. So this one region, sucker, and then this one scholex. So this one neck region. So that is an example of flat helminthus. Example of flat helminthus. Okay. And then next go to for phylum Acelminthus. Acelminthus means round worm. And then or nematoda. So nema means ring or round. And then next one helmin means worm. So round worms. Go. So the term Acelminthus was given by Grubben. Term Acelminthus was given by Grubben. Go. So the general characters of Acelminthus habitats. So most roundworm live as parasites in plants and animals. In plants and animals. And then some are free living in freshwater and marine water. So next one, body form. So body is round and pointed at the both ends. Round and pointed at the both the end. Go. And then unsegmented body. The body form, the body is round and pointed at the both end. And then unsegmented body. So next one, level of organization. Organ level of organization. And then symmetry, bilateral symmetry. And then next one, germ layers diploblastic animals. When an organism develops during this embryonic stage, the third three germ layers are involved: ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. So that is a diploblastic animals. Go. And then next one, body wall. So unsegmented body covered with thin cuticle epidermis and muscle layers are present. So the body was the unsegmented body covered with thin cuticle epidermis and muscle layers. And the next one, body cavity. So body is pseudocoelom. So the body cavity present between body wall and the digestive tract. So that is one body cavity. So this body cavity is pseudocoelom. Pseudocoelom or false coelom. Only in this type of organisms, the coelomic cavity developed during this moving process only. So without moving process, the body cavities cannot form. So that is a pseudocoelom or false coelom. So next one, skeleton. So skeletal system absent. And then digestion. So the digestive system is complete. For example, mouth, pharynx, intestine and anus. So that is a complete development of digestive system. And then circulatory system absent. And then respiration. So the respiration is followed by the process of diffusion method. So already told you diffusion. So next one, excretion. So the excretion process is followed by a specialized cells is called as gland cells. So the excretory product of assessment is ammonia. Except ascaris. So ascaris is an example of assessments. So ascaris, the excretory product, ammonia and urea. So ascaris is otherwise called as ammonia telly animals and urea telly animals. So next one, reproductions. So sexes are separated. So the separate sexes are present. For example, hookworm and then ascaris and then hookworm, ascaris, filarial worm. So that is an example of acelmintas. So the diagram, hookworm, that is a hookworm, then ascaris, so that is a female, and then so that is a male ascaris. And the next one, filarial worm. So that is a filarial worm. The most common disease in human being, elephantiasis and ascariasis. Elephantiasis means mostly elephantiasis disease affected in lymphatic system of human being. And then ascaris mostly affected in small intestine. Go. So next go to for phylum Annelida. So that is a segmented worm. Annulus means segment, and then Leda means worm. So that is a segmented worm. The term Annelida was given by Lamarck. So the general characters of Annelida habitats. So annelids occurs in freshwater and seawater habitats, and then mostly the moist soil habitats. And then next one, body form. So it is a metameric segmentation. So what is called metameric segmentation? The body is externally divided into segments. So that is called as metamers. So this metameric segmentation. Go. And the next one, level of organization. So organ system level of organization. So already told you in this one. And the next one, symmetry. Bilateral symmetry. So bilateral symmetry already explained. And the next one, germ layer. So that is on diploblastic animals. And then next one, body wall. So the body wall is covered with thin cuticles, especially moist thin cuticles, and then epidermis layers and the muscular layers are present. And the next one, body cavity. So it is a first true coelomic animals. And then in the coelomic cavity filled with the fluids called a coelomic fluid. So in the coelomic fluids present in the red color pigment is called as hemoglobin or erythropoietin. So that is on blood substance. So next one, skeletal system option, and then digestion. So the digestive system is well developed. For example, mouth, pharynx, and then intestine and anus. And the next one, respiration process. So that is on cutaneous respiration. So cutaneous means skin respiration. So the respiration take place in skin. So that is a cutaneous respiration. And then next one, circulation. So the circulation is closer type of circulation. Closer type of circulation. So the circulatory blood through the blood vessels and then transported from the each and every part of the body. And then the transporting substance of blood is called as hemoglobin. And then next one, excretion. So excretion is followed by the coiled tube is called as nephridia. Nephridia. So the nephridia is performed by the excretion process of annelida. So excretory product of annelida, urea and then ammonia. Cool. And the next one, reproduction. Hermaphrodites. Reproduction of hermaphrodites. So hermaphrodites means both male and female reproductive organs are present in the same species. So that is called as hermaphrodites. For example, earthworm and the leech. At the same time, the neer is unisexual process. So unisexual means mostly male or female reproductive organs only present in this organism. So that is a unisexual organism. So that is a neer is. Go on. Mostly animal kingdom only 5 phylums are completed, and then all students mostly clear watch this videos. So that is a very important topic of the zoology, very important topic. So in this video all of you all of you seen it clear.